State has their first offensive chance here of the afternoon. Buys it, and then a shot goes over the goal frame. From behind the neck, and now we'll get a nice job from Jake Miller with the active stick. He'll just take a little bit of relief from the pressure on his own cage and a nice side of the there. Miller found his man, lost it out of his pocket, got it up for a moment, and it looks to be Galbraith. He had it for a third, set for a sideline, and another turnover. See, that's going to be a big thing. We saw in the first game that we had called, and that was Concordia against Louisiana, but it's really going to be big. It's what possessing numbers can be. A nice finish. First goal. Nice job from North Dakota State. And a great feet back door. That was Jack Hughes waiting for it there. And he tucked it home, and I saw him do that in the warm-up. Same one. Nice little movement, good cradling, and he gets free and just completely undressed Jake Miller on that one to put it home.
Yeah, it was a nice looking cross, and again, you can just see nice poise on that finish.
So, North Dakota straight, North Dakota State strikes first. Trying to put everything together in one. And we've got 12:37 to go here in this first quarter of play. Minutsuri draw one as well. Bars in, and they're going to take this in. Another chance at some more offense. Working it out of the box. Boys going green. Substitutions coming off for either side. And already seeing both the midfield substitution and the box from this North Dakota State team.
Here comes another one. You see, now it's going to be a foot race. He gets in, he's got a couple steps on him. And Metro State does a nice job of closing that up. But teams will use that as far as their within their strategies. If they can get a guy, you know, freed up through the substitution, that's great.
North Dakota State with a jump shot that goes increase and wide. They maintain possession here. Throws in white. Chess match continues here on field number two from UC Irvine. Worked up top. On the 47. North Dakota State. Marsh. Marsh goes low with that feet. Had a man cutting through. And immediately something I'm noticing is the speed right now of North Dakota State. They've got some good players out there.
They're trying to play fast.
Here comes the low goal score. Nice feed to the front.
Oh, and it bounces in. Unfortunately for Metro State, but that was the look was a nice look. It should have just been a nice save out, but unfortunately, it's missing. One of the reasons that I think North Dakota State wants to play a little faster, if you just look at the size of their bench compared to the size of their bench, they'll wear them down. They'll try to wear down Metro State.
Yeah, and not a lot. Not a deep team here for Metro. We've got only eight on the sideline compared to Metro's, or sorry, extensive lineup here on the near side of the field. 2-0 game. Spencer Marsh had the goal. Kind of went in and out of his pocket there, as you saw. So, kind of just an unfortunate play for Jake Miller in the goal here from Metro. Now a little bit of a loose ball. That's eventually scooped up by North Dakota State. So, another face-off, another possession here. That goes white. And just like that.
Yep. And here comes there again. Once again, they're trying to push the pace a little bit.
Metro is now makes it back into play. And so it is 6-on-6 here. Spray numerically and worked up top. Waiting for him is Noah Simpson. Simpson's just going to wait. More substitutions to be made.
They got the right personnel on, so now they'll set up a new set of offense.
And for the first time, they kind of slowed down a little bit. So we'll see.
That one looks like they're in a 1-3-2 offense.
Work now, and here's another opportunity, but Jack Hughes can get shot off. He has one of the two goals so far here for the State. A chance on the jump shot goes just through the team. Good opportunity from Alex Larson. And it's going to take in the maintain possession of the State. It's going to be an accident as Kevin Sturgeon takes it there. Top again to Larson. Passes it to the near side. There's Noah Simpson. Tries to spin away from the defender. Instead, goes for a pass. Low behind that Sturgeon. And so a turnover here. And from the end line, it'll be a Metro ball. once they get the restart, let's say, so it's magnified the gravity of holding on to possession in a college game. And you can see those quick turnovers like that always seem to catch up with you, but Metro, as you alluded to, they've got a short.
Now,
here's a shot.
Now, North Dakota State is in a 10-man rock. So that's, they're bringing everybody up. They're putting the goalie back to try to pressure the clear. Metro State, you know, they're just looking to get the ball over the top on that. Sometimes you'll score a goal from on the other side of the field because the goal is wide open, because the goalie's up on the man. But that tells you what they're thinking is in terms of going after Metro State. Maybe not a whole lot of, you know, at this point in the game, not a whole lot of respect for the clearing game right now. So they're going to put on that 10-man ride and try to force them to make mistakes.
You had kind of a pop. It was behind the D. Just couldn't quite make it long feet. Here's a backdoor feet. A shot. A big stop.
Just couldn't quite get the handle on it. Looked like he was trying to go high to low, but just couldn't get the ball out of his pot.
Sets and he'll go to work again offensively. First quarter. Passes.
Knocked it down.
Justin Galbraith. Nice. Whistling once again. Kevin Sturgeon. 10 minutes.
Little miscue from Metro State. They thought they were clearing the ball, and one of the defensemen was running up and so he's clearing, and then realized he got back in on time. And again, North Dakota State's in the 10-man. If they're going way up on top of the above the restraining box, he's going to drop in once.
Possession of Galbraith, he's still looking for it. He goes down, and the flag, or no flag, the whistles blow. That looks to be a foul against North Dakota State, resulting in a turnover. So Metro will take this one in. They get the restart quickly as San Diego will take this one in. Metro gaining the box, and now they slow down. Now Metro gets, I think, only their second opportunity, really, at an offensive possession, possibly their third. You know, I've brain rattled around a few times. So.
Well, you know, it's just interesting. I mean, North Dakota State, they're making that statement early on the ride. Hey, we're going to press you all over the field. And their goalie is way up. I mean, he's not even hesitating. So now it seems like they can put something together here.
Once again to San Filippo. They will be taken there by Larson. Larson surveying his options on the field and deciding to try to get the shooting lane for himself. Couldn't do enough spins. Now fires that one wide.
Not a bad take. I'm not sure the goalie saw that, actually. Just by the team's reaction, the ball went behind him. But not a bad take, especially early in the game.
Now it's San Filippo again. Out to the top and a lot of shot there. And there in our frame, but the stop relatively easy.
There's a fast break situation. Slow break now.
Once again, coaching staff, they should take a back and forth as to having their correct players out there in good units.
And if you look down on the defensive side for North Dakota, they're already set up in their 10-man ride. I mean, they're still playing offense, but they're already set up in the 10-man.
It's going to be an interesting one to see if Metro might not be able to capitalize and push Piper back into goal. If they can get one or two by him, they can force the coaching staff to change up their decision making process here. That's the third one already.
Now, if Metro picks up the ball, there it is. He just picks up and throw right to the goal. I mean, that's what I would tell my guys. Look at the goal right away.
There's a nice stick check coming across that midfield line with Galbraith. He loses it. Oh, North Dakota State's on the attack.
We got a flag down.
Worst penalty coming up here on the afternoon. North Dakota State is still with possession. They're just going to ride this one out, working the perimeter, as there will be a penalty coming up against North Dakota State.
So North Dakota State's got a freebie here. They'll take their time, see what they get.
5:42 to go in the first quarter of play. A 2-0 game with Bison leading it right now.
You got that down. And I hope we're saying it right. I mean, that's what I was told by someone from up that way. And I'm going to have to go with that. So maybe if I get a tweet or something saying I'm wrong.
Well, you can.
And I'll take the hit on that one because that's what I was told.
Turnaround jump shot stopped. Nice job by Miller getting up and elevating with that ball as it went low to high. And finally we get that whistle. So the infraction comes. That was a very long freebie, so to speak, for that North Dakota State team. They were able to kind of ride it out a little bit and look for a good chance.
You know, the rules have changed over the years. It used to be as soon as the ball went down, the flag would, the whistle would blow and they'd stop play. Now, as long as you maintain possession of the ball, like, okay, whose ball you pick it up, they won't blow that whistle. So you could go. I mean, you go upwards of a minute, you know, if there's a flag down.
You know, that only puts more emphasis on the officials here. The tight angle shot goes What a connection on that one. And it was Kevin Sturgeon who ends up scoring the man-up goal for North Dakota State, and they seem to really be rolling with some momentum here in the early goings. 5 minutes to go in this first quarter of play, and just like that, 3-0 game.
And it's a game, you know, it's a game of momentum, it's a game of runs. You know, Metro State really needs to get out here and win this faceoff, stop the bleeding a little bit, you know, and get a sustained offense, see what they can get. But no, I mean, North Dakota State's off to a good, they're off to a quick start, you know.
On the faceoff, and it's going to be scooped up. Substitutions as fresh legs come off the bench for North Dakota State. As we're going to take this one, trying to attack. It is Normandin has the ball now.
And again, North Dakota State's back up in the 10-man already. And then what it does is it frees up their defenseman up at the midfield. See, he's not covering anybody right now because he knows that attack was picked up by the goalie.
Here comes an attack once more. Work around the perimeter looking for openings in front of the goal. None to speak of as of now. Sturgeon's just going to keep this ball, work it up top as it comes free, but it's picked up by Alex Larson, and he makes a little bit of a run himself. In and out of the pocket on his pass over to Hughes. Hughes does recover before the sideline. Scoops this one up there. Look once more to move this around. Metro right now, it seems like they've kind of put on their heels with the early three goals. They're looking a little bit slower, not quite the fire in the legs that we saw from North Coast State early on, as the speed has kind of slowed down even from the boys in white as well.
Well, Metro is not looking to slide all that quickly either. I mean, I think they have a lot of confidence in their man-to-man defense, but they're not sliding as quickly as they should, in my opinion. But again, it's a matter of taking the body there. You know, I call it the Colgate syndrome. They're using the sticks, it's going up and down, you know, instead of dipping in, take the body, stand them up. It's to your advantage. But again, right there, same thing. They're not taking the body.
And that's what we hear from the sideline. The coaching staff tries to take your advice on that one. Down into X dispersion. Forte gives a quick little feed out. A chance on a spin and a shot.
I think he's made the save or hit off the pipe, but I'm going to give him the benefit of the doubt, so he made that save.
Normandin was the one with the opportunity. He had another early chance as well. Just before that, he's finally going to sub off here as he'll take a quick breather. North State with possession. to sub off. So the tired guys get some fresh troops out there and all while maintaining possession. So good job here so far from the zone. They've done well to keep possession.
They've controlled. They've controlled the quarter for sure.
Down to just 2:12 to go in this first frame.
Metro. The Roadrunners need a stop here. They need a nice stop.
Goal before this first quarter is out would be nice. Pass comes towards the midfield line. There's the goalie all the way out there. Something new for this. Piper was waiting for that ball. Doesn't end up making it all the way to the midfield line. Here comes North Dakota State once again. A shot from an angle.
I mean, you don't see it all that often, but I like it. I like where they're coming from on this philosophically. Again, they think they can ride. They can ride the ball better, and it's created opportunities for them. Metro State's had a lot of problems clearing the ball. So, you know, as long as it works for them, like I said earlier, as a coach, I look at that and say, if he's that far out and we can clear the ball, I'm looking to throw a long one. I don't care if I score 60 yards out. It's a goal, and he's going to think twice maybe next time about running the 10-man because he kind of figured out, hey, maybe these guys know what they're doing. So,
for a moment, couldn't keep possession. 70 seconds before, it's a North Dakota State ball once again.
What this also does in terms of having setting up the 10-man, and they haven't done it yet, they can run a guy over the midfield line and shoot that open defenseman down, which would create a fast break situation for them. They may not do it, but that's what I would do if I was coaching.
Right. Sturgeon chased it down, and he's going to take it in on the restart whistle. Sturgeon drops through X and trying to come out on the near side. He's looking for a lane to shoot.
Again,
shot 10 from the back door goes in. North Dakota State tucks home another one. That was later on, I believe, on the back post with a nice feed from Kevin Sturgeon, and it's 4-0 just like that.
And that should wipe, the goal should wipe that off. Yeah, that's what the ref's doing. It would have been a hold. So the goal wipes out the goal.
44 seconds left here in the first frame. Not a lot of offense and possession to speak of.
This quarter's been all in North Dakota State. Again, it's about winning these face-offs. Saw there, and then he pulled him up. He has that prerogative to do that.
The boys reset, as do we. Whistle blows, fair face off, nice initially. And that one then will be Victor. Victor trying to attack in the final moments. Working around the perimeter, down low. There is San Filippo trying to come out front, looking for the back post play. It bounces free. And eventually does not end up on a goal frame. Instead, taken by North Dakota State. And a long shot won't even make it on frame before the horn sounds. We're done with the first 15 minutes here from field number two. And it is a 4-0 for North Dakota State on top of Metro. After the first frame, about enough more action from this. Kittinger on block chase. This is MCLA action at last.
Division I MCLA National Champions.
State has captured the National Championship. Grand Canyons are
we'll
your National
care.
Champions. Panthers are the
This is Wilson Field on the campus of Chapman University in Orange, California, where we conclude 6 days, 30 games, and now one champion to crown of the NCLA Championship, powered by Armour. Trying to crunch his way to back of it, he scores!
Oh my goodness, behind the back, the Bucks win it!
Max trying to get something going on a much smaller Colombo. Duncan behind, comes out to front of Blatt, he goes! Nachos win in the sixth overtime!
To the near side, a 1-2 pass to Tarlo.
Come around the bend, that's what he scores! David Carlos falling to the ground, goes Cacatel.
Back to his left hand, turns the corner inside, takes the shot, scores the goal! Conley scores! 19 seconds to play. Sends it inside to Davis. Davis scores the goal!
4 seconds. Hedlund, backdoor shot. He scores!
Shot.
Goal! Oh. Not anymore.
Sit inside and right now. Set a goal!
Shot on the way. Score! Dayton wins!
And your Division I MCLA national champions, the Buffaloes of Colorado.
After the national championship,
celebration time for your national champs.
And that's it, Grand Canyon are your national champions.
3 seconds, 2-1, Panthers
are the first quarter of play, got 4-0 score. North Dakota State on top of the Ventura State Roadrunners out of Denver, Colorado.
So the biggest difference between the Under Armour Command Head and the Command Low is the ability to form a mid to low pocket, whereas the original Command was designed to form a mid to high pocket. It really is the ideal head shape for attackmen and midfielders who like to shoot the ball. Through the narrow profile, it keeps the ball from hanging in the corners of the head, which is going to give players a more accurate shot. Another great benefit of the design is the glide scoop feature, which allows players to pick up ground balls more quickly and efficiently. Coming in at under 5 ounces, the Command Low is a lightweight option that doesn't compromise the performance benefits of the head. The head is constructed of a temperature stabilizing material that helps it hold up throughout the season. If you're a player looking for a lightweight head that delivers power and control, string up the Under Armour Command Low.
It's 4-0 right now, just a minute gone in this second quarter of play. As North Dakota State holds the lead so far down the offensive.
So the biggest difference between the Under Armour Command Head and the Command Low is the ability to form a mid to low pocket, whereas the original Command was designed to form a mid to high pocket. It really is the ideal head shape for attackmen and midfielders who like to shoot the ball. Through the narrow profile, it keeps the ball from hanging in the corners of the head, which is going to give players a more accurate shot. Another great benefit of the design is the glide scoop feature, which allows players to pick up ground balls more quickly and efficiently. Coming in at under 5 ounces, the Command Low is a lightweight option that doesn't compromise the performance benefits of the head. The head is constructed of a temperature stabilizing material that helps it hold up throughout the season. If you're a player looking for a lightweight head that delivers power and control, string up the Under Armour Command Low.
Brooklyn State's out. Central State's got to find a solution here before this game gets way out of hand. Right now they're down five. It's not insurmountable. They can pick their way back. But you're getting to that point of, like, no return.
Especially with the benches as short as the metro.
And again, and North Dakota State winning the faceoff battle. So, you know, that's key. You know, they just keep maintaining possessions. They go out on these 2-3-goal runs.
Lift up top, one score. That's where you take the power city. He just feeds one off quickly. And you hear all these whistles from the other fields, and I keep thinking it's something down on ours, but it's not the case. It continues to play here as it's once more worth hitting it, but now down low. Looking at there is Wiemken. Wiemken finds his mark, and I believe that's Sturgeon behind the goal. They continue to work the perimeter. Long ball, fed out towards midfield line. Wiemken has it there. He's going to make a quick little run in and out of his pocket, though, and he'll just push it back. A nice play, but you're seeing that North Dakota State filling in the lanes where they need to be. And it'll be worked in to Sturgeon and X once again. He just continues along the far side of the field as North Dakota State eventually finds a stick there of player, a shot there from the tight end, off they go. Are going to have 5-0 game. 11:20 to go in this frame. Still waiting on a Metro State goal here in this one. North Dakota State owning all the possession numbers. And there, pass just as I say it, of course, goes
out. That happens. That happens. But again, goals wide open for them. And nobody's really looking to make that quick look to the cage. So,
and it would be a big opportunity for this Roadrunner squad to try and get on the board here. Down 5-0 with 10:51 to go in this second quarter of play. We'll see what Metro comes at them with. And so,
Mitchell State gets one on the board here, stops them leading, settles things down a little bit, but they're playing an awful lot of defense, and they got to really take advantage of this offensive set.
Regardless, possession North Dakota State. And you know, it's a game that was similar to the last one in possession numbers, and what happens is you put on your heels as Metro's been, all of a sudden those guys are just getting worn into the ground. You need to have some offense just to give them at the very least a break from all of this defensive play and being on your heels.
It's the nature of the beast right now. They're trying to find a solution.
Metro is in their last time focusing on offense despite the fact they've been mostly on defense, and they want to try and force NDSU out of the box and up towards the top.
I mean, that's a nice, they're putting better pressure on NDSU's